a physical quantity of the dimensions of length that can be formed out of C and G, and the formula is given E square by 4 pi epsilon naught, where C is the velocity of light and G is the universal constant of gravitation and E is the charge of the particle. Whereas from the formula, what is actually given is the length L, the dimension of the length L can be found out from the three parameters, namely C, G and the formula is given, it consists of charge. So now the L is proportional to E square by 4 pi into epsilon naught power to any one of the parameters, namely called as A, B, C, all the alphabetical order. For comfortable case, I am just putting a alphabetical order P. And then it is also proportional to C. C raised to the power of Q. And then G. G raised to the power of R. So length is the is a standard unit. You know the dimension of the length. And G is also on the previous class discussed about the velocity of the light also. We discussed the dimension of the velocity of light also is known. And whereas capital G also we discussed in the previous class, it is a gravitation, universal constant of gravitation, that also is very well known. Now a new parameter is given here, E square by 4 pi epsilon naught. Whereas E is the charge, E is the charge particle, charge of the particle. Charge of the particle in the sense is maybe the charge of the proton or charge of the neutron, whatever may be. So E simply is called as the charge of the particle, and the unit for the E, nothing but what? Coulomb. The unit for the, or nothing but what? Coulomb. The notation is given as simply C. The C is the dimension for the charge particle. Next comes upon epsilon naught. Epsilon naught talks about the permeability of the free space or permittivity of the free space. In the case of a In the case of a dielectric material or the case of a magnetic electrical field, it determines about the permeability or the permittivity of the free space. Here we are going to calculate, you should be very clear about what is the dimension for the permittivity of the free space and then how to calculate the dimension of the charge particle. Here the formula, the relative permeability is given as epsilon r. Epsilon r is nothing but the dimensionless. The dimensionless is not having any dimension, but one consists of a constant value. So the epsilon r is a relative permeability. It talks about the numerical value, the dimensionless parameter. Whereas epsilon naught is consists of a permittivity, the constant, the permittivity of a free space. It consists of some certain dimension. How to calculate this? The unit for this, this is nothing but Coulomb square Newton minus 1 m minus 2. This is the unit for the relative permeability. Charge, Newton and meter. Once you know the unit, it is easy to write the dimension for the particular unit. So Coulomb square as it is given as what? Coulomb square. And then Newton. Already discussed about the Newton. The formula for the or the unit for the Newton is nothing but kilogram meter per second square. This is the unit for the Newton. So next thing is meter is given. Meter is nothing but as it is a meter. So now, so what is the dimension for epsilon naught alone? Nothing but C square divided by Newton is in the denominator. So n minus 1 is nothing but kilogram meter per second square into m minus 2. So this is the formula for this. Now when I calculate this, so substitute epsilon naught in the formula. So E square divided by epsilon naught. The 4 pi is a value. It is the numerical value. No need to analyze the dimension for that. So E square by epsilon naught is nothing but E square is nothing but the charge of the particle is Coulomb. That is represented in the notation called as C. C is also one dimension. So E square means C square divided by epsilon naught. C square second square m minus 1 and then kilogram meter will be goes upward because denominator of the denominator goes to the numerator. So on this basis, E square by epsilon naught equivalent to C square kilogram meter divided by C square S square m minus 2. So C square will get cancelled. So end up with what? M minus 2 also goes up. So you are already 1 will be there. M minus 2 means m plus 2 will be there. So becomes what? Kilogram meter cube divided by second square. So the dimensional for this is nothing but kilogram is mass, L is nothing but L cube, T is T minus 2. So this is the dimension for the charge particle, nothing but E square by 4 pi epsilon naught. So the formula for E square by 4 pi epsilon naught is nothing but M L cube T minus 2. M takes a value 1. So M1 L cube T minus 2. The rest of the parameter already discussed. So already we know the dimension value for the remaining two parameters. Only the new parameter is discussed now. So just join together, put a derive an equation. Just it is easy to solve what is the value for P, Q and R by the previous methods. So I am just substitute the value for E square by 4 pi epsilon naught as such. M power 1 L cube T minus 2. And velocity is already known, that is LT minus 1. The universal gravitational constant dimension is also already seen many times. That nothing but m minus 1 L cube T minus 2. Just according to the principle of homogeneity, the left hand side that is equivalent to the right hand side. Here the proportional sign is also, no need to bother about that. If you remove the proportional sign, constant will be a numerical value. No need to analyze the formula for that. So here the left, according to the principle of homogeneity, we are discussing all the dimensional formula. So according to this, left hand side is equivalent to right hand side. So just compare the m value in both the categories, in all the formula. So p takes a value only 1. So 1 into nothing but what? P. P, q is not having a m value and r is having a m value of about minus 1. So p minus r, that is equivalent to 0. Because the left hand side, there is no m value, so takes a value of 0. This is your equation number 1. Next, consider the L value in both the equations. So L value means L nothing but L3. So P takes a, multiply with the P, P takes a value of 3P. 3P plus Q. L is 1, so nothing but L into Q, nothing but Q. And here is plus 3R. That is equivalent to 1. This is equation number 2. Next, consider about the time value. So time value in the both the side, left hand side as well as in the right hand side. So time value in the both the side, minus 2p, minus 2p, here is minus q and here is minus 2r, that is equivalent to 0. This is equation number 3. So this is somewhat seems to be a equation in which I am not able to get any parameter from these three equations. So I am going to take equation number 2 and 3. I am going to solve the equation 2 and 3. So if I solve the equation 2 and 3, so from this 2 and 3, so simply I just calculate, simply if I add the equation, the q seems to be plus and minus. So while adding, there is no need to change the sign of the any one of the values. So as it is, q get cancelled up, p minus 3, there is 3p minus 2, nothing but what? 1p. So 1p here is also nothing but plus 1r, that is equivalent to 1. So P plus R equivalent to, this is equation number 4. P plus R is equivalent to 1. So comparing equation 1 and 2, 1 and 4, compare this equation 1 and 4. I got some value in terms of P and terms of R. So I am going to equate, I am going to solve the equation number 1 and 4. So that I can able to find out any one of the parameter. So P minus R is equivalent to 0. Whereas P plus R equivalent to 1. So when I add these two equations as such, R get cancelled, 2P equivalent to 1. So P value is 1 by 2. So I got the value for the P, it seems to be half. Next, substitute the value of P in any one of the equations. So I am going to substitute the value of P in equation 1. So P minus R is equivalent to 0. P takes a value of half. Half minus R equivalent to 0. So R minus R equivalent to minus half, in which r equivalent to half. Again I got the value for r is equivalent to half. So just minus r equivalent to 0, it goes down, minus r equal to minus r, so r equivalent to half. So I got the value for p and r, it seems to be the same value as half. Next my aim is to calculate what is the value for q. So for finding out the value for q, substitute the value of p and r in equation 2. So 3p plus q plus 3r, that is equivalent to 1. So 3 into half plus q plus 3 into r takes a value of half, that is equivalent to 1. So 3 by 2 plus 3 by 2, if I take LCM becomes what? 6 by 2. So 6 by 2 plus q, that is equivalent to 1. 6 by 2 nothing but 3. 3 plus q equivalent to 1. So q takes a value of 1 minus 2. Sorry, minus 3. Our q value is minus 2. So I got the value for q is nothing but minus 2. Now substitute all the values of p, q, r in the above equation. If I substitute in this equation, L is proportional to E squared by 4 pi epsilon naught power half. C is nothing but power, Q takes a value of minus 2. G takes a value of half. So, the L is proportional to, that is E squared by 4 pi epsilon naught power half into G power half divided by C squared. So, this is the final answer I end up with. This is the final answer because C power minus 2, C power minus 2, this comes down, becomes C square. So this is the only answer is given in the option. In the 4 option, the C square is comes down. Because of this reason only, I just put the C square in the downward. So this is the option given, this is one of the option given in the above question. This is the final answer end up with. So many problems or comes with universal gravitation constant, and then next to this Planck's constant. You should be very familiar with the dimensions of universal constant and the dimension of the velocity of a light, or the dimension of velocity, and then a Planck's constant. So if you know about these basic things, you can proceed with the dimensional formula. So now this also consists of some universal gravitation constant G. And then the new topic, a new word, new physical variable, namely called as Planck's constant. The Planck's constant H is given, and speed of light in vacuum is also given, a notation is C. Speed of light is nothing but, it talks only about the velocity of a light. And then G is a gravitational, universal gravitational constant, or the three fundamental constants are given, of which you should be frame the combination to the dimension of length. Now, the length, again the previous, it consists of the same previous phenomena. That is, length is proportional to three factors, namely called as h, is h to the power of a, or speed of light is c is given to the power of b, and then g is also given to the power of c. Our aim is to calculate what is the value of a, b and c. Before going to that, a new word is given over here is nothing but Planck's constant. So de Broglie wavelength of light, de Broglie wavelength, come across this word namely called as Planck's constant. The formula is nothing but E equivalent to H into nu. So E is the case of a laser, the spontaneous emission or the movement of the electrons from one place to another point, it should absorb the radiations of E equivalent to H nu. Whereas E is the energy of the particle, whereas H is the Planck's constant, and nu is the frequency, in which the nu is the frequency. So you should, on the previous session itself, I come across what is the formula for the energy and how the dimension should be derived, also we seen in the previous class. Now a new thing is nothing but what H have to be calculated. So H is nothing but, from the first equation I can say H is nothing but E divided by nu, where E talks about the energy of the particle and nu is frequency. So energy also nothing but power into time, the power nothing but work done by time into time. The energy dimension is also derived already. A new dimension, the new physical parameter nothing but frequency. The frequency dimensions to be derived. How? Now the formula or the definitions for the frequency or the unit for the frequency, think back, the frequency unit is hertz. So how you define the hertz, how you define the frequency, think back, cycle, cycle per second, one cycle per second or two cycles per second. The cycle talks only about the complete rotation of the particle. So cycle, nothing but the formula or the definition for the frequency or the definition for the hertz, it gives only the number of revolutions per unit time. Nothing but number of cycles per unit time. Cycle takes only a numerical value. So hertz, in simply I can say hertz takes a value of 1 by second, nothing but 1 by t, the dimension value is t minus 1. So always when you comes upon a word frequency, the dimension for the frequency is t minus 1. So from this formula, and then already discussed about what is the dimension value for energy. So you know the dimension value for the frequency now. So just comparing these two, you can able to calculate the dimension formula for the h. So the dimension formula for the frequency is just now derived. And next step is I want to calculate what is the formula for the h, Planck's constant. So Planck's constant nothing but E by nu. The Planck's constant for nothing but what? H equivalent to E by nu. E is the energy. So energy comes from the formula power into time. Power nothing but work done by time into time. Already discussed about the energy dimension in the previous class. According to this, energy takes the value of m1 l square t minus 2. Just now we saw the frequency for the dimension. Frequency dimension is t minus 1. If I express the frequency in the form of m l t, so m takes a value of 0, l takes a value of 0, t holds a value of minus 1. So according to that, m 0, l 0, t minus 1 takes a value for the frequency. Now h is equivalent to m as such will be m, l is also will be l square, but t 1 minus 1 goes upward becomes plus 1, t minus 1. So this is the dimension for the Planck's constant. So now based on this equation number a, so now substitute the value of h, c and g, and just automatically by the previous application just find out the according to the equation of principle of homogeneity, just get the value for a, b, c and then substitute in the equation 1. So next thing is l is equivalent to as proportional to h. H is m 1 l square t minus 1 power a. C is the velocity of light, nothing but m l t minus 1. So m takes a value of 0, m is nothing but velocity of a light is l t minus 1, m 0 l 1 t minus 1 power b. So universal constant, that nothing but m minus 1 l cube t minus 2. So l is proportional to h, h dimension value is noted over here. And c is the velocity of light, the velocity dimension formula is lt minus 1, and gravitational constant g takes a value of m minus 1 l cube t minus 2. Now this l nothing but l power 1, so l power 1 is equivalent to m 1 l square t minus 1 power a, m 0 l 1 t minus 1 power b, m minus 1 l cube t minus 2 powers. So according to the principle of homogeneity, it is left hand side is equivalent to right hand side. RHS is must compulsory is equivalent to LHS. So based on this, just comparing the left parameters in the left hand side as well as in the right hand side, I come to the conclusion that m takes a value of 1, so a, and b vandu b m is 0. So no need to worry about that. C holds a value of minus C, so minus 1, that is equivalent to 0. This is the equation number 1. Next, consider about L parameter in both the sides. A nothing but 2A, 2A, whereas for the B nothing but plus B, and for C it consists of plus 3C. Right hand side holds a value of only 1L, so is the equation number 2. Similarly, for the time period, just evaluate the value minus a, and then similarly for minus b, minus 2c, that is equivalent to 0. This is equation number 3. So just compare this equation number 3, I have to calculate the value for the constant namely called as A, B and C. Okay, the equation number 2 and 3. I am just going to take the equation number 2 and 3. So if I compare this equation 2 and 3, B get, if I added this two equation, B get B reduced, the value becomes what? A, simply 1A. 1A plus C, that is equivalent to 1. So, again I am getting a critical equation namely called as A plus C, that is equivalent to 1. From equation 1, I can reduce A equivalent to C is one category. Now, comparing equation 1 and 4, 1 and 4, A minus C, that is equivalent to 0, this is equation number 1. When I compare these two equations, simply adding it out, 2A equivalent to 1, A nothing but 1 by 2. So I got the value for A equivalent to 1 by 2. Another equation is also there, A equivalent to C. So on this basis, A and C takes a value of half. So my main aim is to calculate what is the value for the B right now. So for finding out the value for B, so, I am taking this equation number 3. Equation 3 is very simple, minus A minus B minus 2C, that is equivalent to 0. So, A value is half. So, minus half minus B minus 2 into half. C value is also half, that is equal to 0. So, minus half minus B, 2 get cancelled, minus 1, that is equivalent to 0. So, minus B, that is equivalent to 1 plus half. So, B were nothing but 3 by 2. So, minus B equivalent to 3 by 2. So, B value is 3 by 2. Minus 3 by 2. B value is nothing but minus 3 by 2. So, I just got the equation for A, B and C. Just substitute the value of A, B and C in the equation A. So, ultimately, if I substitute the value of A, B and C in the equation number A, so L is nothing but proportional to H power half and C power minus 3 by 2 and G power half. So nothing but L is equivalent to or is proportional to root of HG divided by C power 3 by 2. This is the final answer. This is the answer given in one of the options. This is the final conclusion from the above. The dimension of half epsilon naught E square is given, where epsilon naught is permittivity of free space and E is electric field. The previous problem I discussed about what is epsilon naught. So we derive the formula based on that, what is epsilon naught, and we find the dimension formula for that. But here the dimension of half epsilon naught E square is given. This half epsilon naught E square is nothing but electric intensity, or it talks about the electric density. Electric density is nothing but mu E. The mu E formula is half into epsilon naught into E square. So magnetic flux density having a particular formula, and similarly electrical density, this value half epsilon naught E square, it talks about the electrical density. It talks about electrical density. The notation for that is mu E. No need to go for a epsilon naught. Epsilon naught dimension is not necessary over here. They ask to evaluate what is the dimension of this parameter. If you are very familiar in the formula, the half epsilon naught E square talks only about the density of the flow of current. It talks only about the electric density. So electric density formula is energy by volume. The formula for nothing but energy by volume. Already we discussed about the dimension for the energy, and then volume is also discussed. So the energy by volume, energy is m power 1 L square T minus 2. This is the dimension for the energy, and the volume is simply L cube. So directly you can find out the dimension for the this parameter, namely called as half epsilon into E square. So m takes a value of 1, L square will be L square, L minus 3 will be the L minus 1 T minus 2. This is the dimension of the half epsilon naught into E square. So So very simply, if you are very familiar in the formula, directly you can find it out. Now another method is also there. Just find out the formula for the epsilon naught, and then you know about the, what is the energy dimension. Just compare, the same thing will be there. But it is very easier if you are very familiar in the formula. So for finding out the dimensional value, you should be very familiar with the unit or with the formula. So from this, is I am concluding is the unit and the formula is, if you are known very well, it is very easy to evaluate the dimension value. So now this is the another thing, the new type in which the option A, B, C is given. We have to suitably fix it up in the equation. The dimension for the physical quantity doesn't mention the name of the physical quantity. As such, they are given the dimension of the physical quantity is seems to be m power a, l power b, and t power c as such. And then the physical, various physical quantity are listed over here with the parameter, namely the exponential value as a equivalent to 1, b equal to 0, and c. There are so many options as given with the physical name of the physical quantity. Suitably, we have to adopt, we have to frame in the above equation. First thing is, velocity is given. So velocity as such, the dimension of the velocity nothing but L t minus 1. This is the dimension for the velocity, in which if I express the dimension of the velocity is with the square brackets in the form of a m L t. M takes a value 0 because no m value in the dimension formula for the velocity. The m takes a value 0, L is 1, t is minus 1. But they are given the physical parameter, physical quantity is velocity, in which they listed out the value for a equivalent to 1. So m takes a value of a. So according to my dimension formula, a value is 0. My option according to this, a takes a value of 0, b takes a value of 1, whereas c takes a value of minus 1. This is the formula, actually this is the dimension formula I just listed over here. So if I put up this value is m a is 0, here the given is m a is 1. So this option is wrong. Accordingly, if the velocity is the actual parameter, means I have to get the exponent value of a to be 0, b to be of 1, c to be of minus 1. So this is not suitable for the first option, velocity. So this answer is wrong. Next comes for acceleration. Acceleration is nothing but the rate of change of velocity. The rate of change of velocity is nothing but v divided by t. So v nothing but lt minus 1 divided by t. This is the dimension formula for the acceleration. So L t minus 2, this is the formula for the acceleration. So if I express the acceleration in terms of m L t, means m 0, t is 1, L is 1, t is minus 2. So my option for a equivalent to 0, b is 1, and t is minus 2. So actually, when I derive the formula, dimension formula for the acceleration, my exponent value is a to be 0, b to be 1, and t to be minus 2. So here the physical quantity is given acceleration, but the option, first option is a equivalent to 1. That is not suits with the actual formula. So second option is also ultimately wrong. Like that, you have to go proceed with force also. And then third thing is pressure. Pressure normally it takes value of nothing but force by area. The formula for the pressure is nothing but force by area. So force, the area nothing but L square, and you are very familiar about the force. Force is nothing but work into displacement. So nothing, so actually if I suit this value, when I compare this value, you definitely will be getting the option for A, B, C to be as what, 1, minus 1 and minus 2. Force is nothing but mass into acceleration. How to derive the force? Force as a third option for us is nothing but force. So for that, m into a, mass into acceleration. Mass as such will be mass. Acceleration value, just now we did nothing but takes a value of rate of change of velocity. So lt minus 2. So according to my formula, it takes a value m lt minus 2. So for force, m is 1, l is also 1, t is also minus 2. So a takes a value of 1, b takes a value of 1, t takes a value of minus 2. The third option, they are given the force formula. First, A option is 0. So according to my dimension value, A should get a value of 1. So this option is also wrong. So finally, I am going for the fourth option, namely called as pressure. Nothing but force by area. So just now I derived the formula for force. Force equal nothing but mass into acceleration. So I getting the dimension formula for the force is nothing but mLt minus 2 divided by area. Area is square of the formula, the L square. So now simplify this. M, the L goes upward, minus 2. Already 1 is there, minus 2 will be there. So mL minus 1, t minus 2. M takes a value of 1. So this is the formula for the pressure. This is the formula for the pressure. Pressure equivalent to force by area. So now accordingly, my value for A seems to be 1, B nothing but minus 1, C takes a value of minus 2. According to the power, I got it from the formula. This is the exponential value for the pressure. This is given as A equivalent to 1, B equivalent to minus 1, C equivalent to minus 2. So from this, the exponent value is actually suits only for the pressure. So pressure, I got the value of A equivalent to 1, B equivalent to minus 1, and C equivalent to minus 2. Just substitute the value of all the A in the above equation. M takes a value of 1, L takes only of minus 1, and T takes a value of minus 2. So this is the correct answer. That should be enclosed in the big bracket. M power 1, L minus 1, and T minus 2. This is the dimension formula for the pressure.